Yeah, we did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I had to tighten the plan. Yeah, I got it right in the end. Ay. Now we on top, top once again. I don't want it if it ain't love. If it ain't get it away from me. Who you gon' jack if it ain't us? LABB to the bakery. Some mad that I came up. I know my granny gon' pray for me. It was just us in the vacancy. We had to get it from A to B. Wheels never felt like this. Two seats in the hills, I feel right.
It is a bright, sunshiny day here in the desert southwest, and the temperature comfortable enough that they said, hey, let's open the roof. That's what they've done here at State Farm Stadium, just west of downtown Phoenix. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Detroit Lions and the Arizona Cardinals. First carry for Dalvin Cook, and not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26.
On the tackle.
Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
Play action. Now it's Murray. Buying time to his left. And a first hookup with his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. A gain of 13, it's a first down.
First and 10 at the 39-yard line.
Gun. Here's Murray. That'll be complete to Cook. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space. It turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
And he'll get it down here to the 43.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run. And let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down. Otherwise, it's going to be a long afternoon.
So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 43. They fake the handoff. Now Murray. Connection made with Chenault. 7 yards, the pickoff on the pitch and catch.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion and would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
Throwing again on second down. Murray flushed out right. On the run, he'll let it go deep, right sideline. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long way way out there, but it'll be third down.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
Now Murray off play action. Flush to his right. Bears it out toward the corner of the end zone. Thrown across his body, and it's intercepted. Snags it for the pick, and he will bring it out past the 20-yard line. They may have thrown the interception, obviously less than ideal, but I think they also sent a message that they're going to push the ball downfield in this one.
Yeah, not afraid to take their shots right away, huh? What was that, like a 9-9-9 route? 9 meaning go? Just went ahead and went for it. Didn't work out so well because it certainly appeared the defense was prepared. But I'm with you. Okay, so it didn't work this time. Doesn't mean we won't try it again later.
After the interception, here's Goff. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. They lose the yardage, and of course, they also lose the down on the grounding call, and it's quickly second and long. From the gun, here's Goff. Catch is made by Hockenson, the tight end.
Pass complete to T.J. Hockenson. A gain of 30.
So that play much needed there as they're all the way up near the 40 for a first and 10. Now the first carry for Bryce Love. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. This gain not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two.
First down, Detroit.
So into Cardinal territory now. It's first and 10 at the 48-yard line. Out of the gun, Goff. Open man, he's got him, the tight end, Hockenson. They'll contain him to just 4, second down.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
To throw again on second down, Goff. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play.
I always fuck up her name. I don't know why. I know I don't let anyone talk to you like that, Kinzer. Well, I know why. I'm just saying, like.
They'll need to get this to the 38.
You can't let Max talk to you like that. That is disrespectful.
And it's gone. And he comes back with one complete. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. 11 yards there and a line first down. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Quick toss by Goff is complete. He's got a first down and much more inside the 20. And did he get in? No. Down at the 1 yard line. A gain of 32 that time. That's how you draw up the run pass option right there. You get a chunk play out of it.
And you know, quarterbacks love to throw the RPOs because oftentimes they're in breaking routes, but receivers love it even more. The ball gets to them quickly, allows them to put some moves on in the secondary.
I don't know, dude. Max is a pretty low center of gravity.
And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal.
And this is why the defense coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers.
Yeah, it was 9-0, right?
To make the play.
Yeah, Kenzer, you might, maybe if you were like 3 people helping you with it, then I'm sure you'd be able to. But one, that's a big task to ask.
On second and goal, Goff, and he's got his man. It's caught for the line.
Dude, again, I don't think those things that support that much. Like, he's not going to have the traction. He's not going to have the traction.
And the Lions are going to take the first quarter lead. It's up, it's good, and the Lions lead 7-0.
Score Lions 7, Cardinals nothing.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 the score as they start first and 10. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
Second and 6.
Play fake, Murray. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Incomplete. Brings up third down.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. Throwing is Murray on third down. Completion to Hopkins, and he is going to have a Cardinals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Back in Arizona, second quarter action. It's the Cardinals in possession as they've got it with a first and 10. Shotgun now for Murray, going deep for Hopkins. That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown Cardinals. DeAndre Hopkins, 58 yards. And the Cardinals are just an extra point away from tying this game. And he knocks it through.
That ties the game at 7. Brett Maher is set to kick off.
So are they good, though? Now as they kick it away.
Boy, how many flavors are there? I know they have the pineapple, lime, strawberry.
Out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25.
What are you talking about? I'm confused.
They were successful last time.
Yeah, I thought you were talking about.
And they get another shot here with a first and 10.
Yeah, that's what I was talking about.
Behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second.
Well, yeah, it's an 8%. It's an 8% Celsius. Oh, shit.
A shotgun snap for Goff. He's going to look deep down the field. And I think that one might have been intercepted, but he will be ruled out of bounds. So this will go only as incomplete.
Love the idea, love the concept, but you got to leave a little room on the sideline so he can fade into it when he makes the catch. That was thrown too close to it for the receiver to make a play.
Throwing on third, Goff. Forced out to his left. He's got his man, TJ.
Dude, I hate playing this fucking guy.
The Lions first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
You really sound like a fucking horse.
And that's where the play began, the 24-yard line. On first down, here's Love. Room here to run. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first.
Coming in, he really liked his chance of having a big year based on a terrific offseason. And runs like that on opening weekend show that he's right.
So into Cardinal territory now. It's first and 10 at the 38. Goff now to throw. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
Incomplete. You could tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
They work again from the 38 on second and 10.
Dude, I hate playing game. Holy shit. Motion slants, crosses, and corner outs all game.
Goff. Eluding the pressure right. And they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete.
Well, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only one.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
Now they face a 3rd and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Goff now looking to throw. Looking downfield for Godwin. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Justin Simmons. And a great return as he's up close to the 40-yard line.
I know some teams are leery about playing cover two because a strong safety is not usually a terrific cover guy. But in this case, he played it perfectly. Read the football and went and made the interception.
They start the drive with Cleveland,
and he'll lose yardage
on the play back at the 37-yard line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11.
This defense is really flown around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense got to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
On 2nd and 11 now, Murray being chased out left. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm, incomplete. Now it's 3rd down.
It's nothing like pressure to affect the accuracy and the timing of a guy trying to throw the football. And on that play, they ended up flushing him to his left, contacted him as he's trying to throw the football, and that led to the incompletion.
To throw on 3rd down, Murray.
Oh, horrible throw. Wanted to fucking be able to lead him.
So it'll be incomplete, certainly one they'd like to have back as it brings up 4th down. Here comes the Cardinals punter now. Jamal Agnew is deep to return it. This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. And this will depend on the spot as it sails out of bounds. And they'll say it sailed out at the 10-yard line.
Not recently.
Absolutely a great coffin corner.
Yeah.
Someone's put some time in working on that, hasn't it?
Seems like every year these guys get better and better. It's amazing how they can command that football through the air.
Yeah, they used to actually practice with hula hoops.
Did Bud Light come out with the lemonade? I legit, like, never fucking seen it.
So much of the game today, we're looking for hybrid players.
I've never seen it. I've never seen it.
Plays a strong safety position.
This is a crossover.
Is a hybrid type player. Half defensive back that covers passes and half linebacker that makes tackles. We just saw the linebacker make that play.
They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a 1st down. Detroit. Now Goff. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's 2nd down.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep 2 eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting 2 hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit. Even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
Got him, Isaiah.
Looking for Godwin.
Are they gonna call that roughing, bro?
And they nearly get this all the
oh,
way
legal man
downfield.
Lucky ass call.
Well,
but I'll take it.
You've got to stay close to home. If you're more than a yard downfield, they're gonna toss that flag, and they did there. They'll fake the handoff. Now Goff.
I'm coming strong when you know that. Good play, Byron.
That'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on. 3rd down.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
Hopefully he doesn't have a fucking post.
3rd down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 15.
He's got a touchdown.
He's going to air one out.
That's the one thing I hope he didn't have me have it.
Open, complete, and all the way down to the 26. A big play on 3rd down for the Lions. 57 yards. So that changes things in a big way. Now from all the way down inside the 30, here's 1st and 10. Shotgun handoff now for Love. And he'll get 2 or 3 out of that one as that is going to take us to the 2-minute warning.
I've definitely seen them.
We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll again head down to visit with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando, back for another year. He'll have scores from around the NFL here on this opening weekend. Escaping the pressure right.
Dude, I hate playing him. Dude is such a faggot. Delay fades and crossers and corners and shit like that. Like, can't cover everything.
Yeah, these one-handed catches, that was great, and they're fun. They're becoming a little more ho-hum, aren't they?
Yeah, they really are. And I know that it sounds like we're taking credit away from the guys, and we don't mean that at all. They really work hard on this one-handed catch thing, but I think the gloves have to be
helping. I really mean Byron Obama, man.
He'll get this down inside the 5 to 4 before he's out of bounds. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch
the Bengals only are for Goblin or Goddard a one-year deal.
On second down, Love, and he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. Not enough there for a first. No gain, as a matter of fact. And it leaves him.
Burn was an awful deep ball passer, and that's what he's good at. You clearly never watched the Kenny Goddard play, bro. The jump ball receiver.
And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game.
Score, Lions 14. Cardinals.
Yeah, you act like he's only good at that. That's what he's best at. He's a contested catcher, or like that's what he's good at. He's not gonna be like a fucking D-hop and absolutely shed a corner's ankles. Well, he doesn't get a huge amount of separation, but he has the most catcher catches in the league since 2016. He's missed a lot of time. Evan Ingram, aha. Hilarious. Laughing so hard.
You could never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face, and analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
That ball complete to Isabella.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score.
He'll rifle this one deep right, and that's caught inside the 35. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half.
34-yard line.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. On play
touchdown.
Action, it's Murray.
Or not.
And
it's okay.
Incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and 10. Actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over, then they get a chance to continue their drive.
This is Chenault on the receiving end. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. 9 yards.
You were literally in the chat hyping
up. So third and less than a yard. The last catch nearly got him a first, but it did not. And they'll try to convert on third and inches. Throwing again, Murray. And he's got an open man. It's Gronkowski. And he is out of bounds, but first he gets it inside the 10 to the 7. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
First and goal at the 7-yard line.
Murray's going to keep this himself on the
RPO. That was total accident, too. He did not know what that was a read option. That was a touchdown, too. Fuck.
To go here in half number one.
Lions 11-yard line.
So they get pushed back to the 11, and here's second and goal.
This might be men.
Out of the gun, here's Murray. Flushed out right. To the end zone, but it's incomplete. LaVisca Chenault, the intended target. But now it's third and goal.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks...
Not even close.
Defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
The Cardinals forced to burn their third and final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. And no move to take the offense on the field. They're going to stay out there and go for it on fourth and goal.
I should have ran a fucking toss. Motherfucker, he didn't care about the middle.
To the 2 yard line. They're turned away on fourth and goal. And the Lion defense able to come up there with a goal line stand. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And now their defense came through with a goal line stand, got them the ball back.
Safety. At the safety. Let's go.
No signal. Yes, it's a safety. And you know, the man who sat in my chair the last few years, he has a theory. These plays, these safeties, they're so rare. Maybe they should be worth more than 2, maybe 4 points.
I think he's got a great point. I really do, Brandon. But I would go ahead and up it.
Do I try a 67-yard field goal?
To me, that's like scoring a touchdown.
No, I got Brett Maher. I'm not making it. I'm not making it. I got Brett Maher as my kicker.
So good field position for the Cardinals as they come up first and 10. Right at the 50-yard line. A final shot before half for Murray. That'll be complete to Cook. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there. So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend. As now we send you out to Orlando and hook back up with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Offense ready to kick off their next drive. We have not seen much on offense here from either side these last few drives. We've hit a wall, so to speak.
And have hit it hard, haven't we? Because the defenses right now, they seem to be a step ahead, don't they? Beating them to the point of attack, beating them to the punch. These offensive guys, they're tinkering like crazy. What's it going to take to get back on track?
Yeah, both sides searching for adjustments. First down, Love, and he'll lose yardage here, back at the 47, 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
And that's what this defense is going to need to do more in the second half. Good pressure that time, forces some indecision in the backfield, and he's going to wind up being taken down for a nice loss.
On second and 12, Goff. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 15 yards on the play, first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Goff on first down. Out to the left there and complete to the tight end, Hockenson. 7 yards the pick up there. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. My cousin said it was
definitely the same. I'm stopping.
They'll run with Love.
There you go, Isaiah.
And he is met quickly in the backfield.
Nah, no way.
Folded like a lawn chair.
I can't rush to you either. Can't see him on cover four.
Side, it's the tight end Hockenson, and he is going to have a Lions first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Great way to convert on third down there. 21 yards the play. Inside 4 minutes to go, third quarter. Option play, and Kaepernick is going to run with it. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line.
God damn, the Ravens got in the seat at 6 interceptions.
That's really nice play, be able to stack that one up. When they get back in the huddle, he's got to tell his guys up front, great job. They kept people off of him, allowed him to run free, and make the hit on the runner.
Filled the gap nicely, kept him to just a 1-yard gain.
Oh.
And he almost had him defensively. Could have been a game changer there in the second half. Instead, it's third down.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be
that would have
offense.
Been game changing, if I call it that. Fuck.
To throw is gone. Flush to his right. This will be caught.
Fuck, dude, that hurts.
Six. And he'll get this down inside the 5 to the 4 before he's out of bounds.
I mean, it's kind of my fault. I lucked the shit out of him. I hit the button too early. You don't know him. Fuck. Oh. That stings.
The offense staying out. They're going to go on 4th and 2.
Yo, 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 what's up, my dudes?
They go ahead yeah. And snap it. Gone. He's got his man. It's Jeez, caught for a Lion touchdown.
What's up?
Jared Goff with his third touchdown pass of the afternoon. Yeah. And the Lions are able to grow their lead. That seemed pretty ideal there for the offense, Charles. You take a little bit of time off the clock here in the third quarter, decent length drive, and you pad your lead as well at the end of it.
And what it does is let you feel like you're in control of this game even more so.
Who do I be?
Lead, right? Because you have taken that time off, as you noted, which means they couldn't get you off the field. You ran your playbook the way you wanted to, and you gave your defense some rest. What a big time drive in that situation.
What about AD? No, oh, no. I'm going with the Truex.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
It's a 30 of 30 right now at Dover. But
throwing on first down is Murray.
Should be
he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. LaVisca Chenault, the intended target, but it'll be second down.
I did see that. Fucking dumbass.
Sack of the game instead. They're able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
Second and 10, third quarter of the season opener.
Heartbreaking for change.
They fake the handoff. Now Murray. Connection made with Chenault. And that'll be good for 8 yards to the 45.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good edge steal going.
And Cook was fighting for it, but I don't think he got there.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
It's fourth down.
Ah, shit.
How about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard. They do go for it. It's Murray. And he finds Cook. And he's got enough for the first across midfield to the 48. A big roll of the dice on fourth and one, but it pays off. They convert.
I'm moving with it. Yeah.
So a moment to catch our collective breath after the fourth.
And I left that bitch still up.
We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. First down, here's the run with Cole. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will. 40-yard
line. 30.
From the 40 now on second down. Murray, he gets this one into the hands of Dalvin Cook. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions 18.
Nah, it wasn't a Sheets earlier for sure.
Good, you were just in the completion there. When they look at the scoreboard, they do understand a field goal is not going to do them any good. My guess, they got to press the ball downfield as far as possible, try and throw it into the end zone and get a score because they know they've got to get that done and get the ball back as quickly as possible.
He'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second down.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short game.
You don't like beer?
Yeah, I was going to say what? Action.
This one caught by
I'm going to grab another beer, by the way.
Set up with a first and goal on a pass play that moves him all the way down to the one. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. At the 1 yard line. They'll run with Cook. And he is in for 6. Touchdown, Cardinals. Punching it in from a yard away. And the Cardinals draw a bit closer. And this is back to a 5-point game.
Makes the score Lions 21, Cardinals 16.
Never mind. I got the kid instead.
Turn on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Lions take over first and 10 at their own 25 yard.
I think it's 29. That Miami.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They've been rolling the last couple of drives, each ending in touchdowns. So this game is flipped. They were down, now they're up with the football. We'll see how they handle it.
Can we get a spy on the headset now between the head coach and offensive coordinator? Because they've been in attack mode. Had to get back into the game. Now they have the lead. Do you stay on the attack? Or do you
And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Buda Baker with a pick. And the return will be stopped at the 34-yard line. Some good games around the league here early in week one, and this one shaping up to be as good as any of them as we come up on a first and 10. And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't.
And he is in the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. DeAndre Hopkins.
In the last one. Well, they're all in the
And the Cardinals have retaken the lead. All right, now a big 2-point conversion attempt still to come. From the gun, Murray. And this one's caught. And their fourth quarter.
Might be able to concede in one more time, though.
So they make the decision. They want a three-point lead versus a two-point lead, and they got it.
Yeah, at this stage of the game, it seems like the exact right thing to do. Put a little pressure on your defense, but the biggest thing now is you're making the other team chase you.
It's still 30-30. At their own 25-yard line. Jesus.
The Lions offense ready.
It's a really good lot. It is like no trolls, bro. It's really good. Like Miami's usually a shit show. There have been like one. There's been like one wreck. Might like lap five, four or five. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the on the straightaways, it is, because it's so narrow. Down. And it's so tight when you come around. The corner.
Now it's gone.
Why?
He's got a first down and then some at midfield. And finally taken down at the 44-yard line.
That's hilarious.
They had a gain of 10 last time, now a gain of 20 here.
First down, Detroit.
We saw a number of good games earlier today. This one might top all of those.
Wait,
it's
what?
Been a dandy as we come up on first and 10.
Oh, shit.
Chandler Jones, a former All-Pro, in on the tackle.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
Now this one to his running back out of the backfield. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down. And with that last play,
I think
now
either of those
that 300-yard mark.
Whoever wins that game.
In NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing
game. Syracuse is
game,
always fucking good in the tournament. Why do you ever count out Syracuse in the tournament?
He's achieved that in this performance.
Doesn't matter what their regular season is. They're always fucking amazing in the tournament. Because that fucking zone, for whatever reason, teams just stoove against
yards. Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown.
If we lose to Morehead State on Friday, I will cry. So fucking nuts. Nice.
Here's gone.
He's got I didn't see. I saw you still missing. What happened?
Four touchdown passes now for Jared Goff. And the Lions.
It's going to be Loyola, right?
Take the lead. And he's able to put it through.
Makes the score Lions 28, Cardinals 24.
Same thing with Oklahoma, right? When your best player just lost it.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Cardinals take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Arizona's offense at the line, ready to get their drive started. And the points, they have come fast and furious in this quarter.
You really don't want to be on the defensive side of the ball right now, do you? Because you're either thinking, my replacement may get an opportunity.
Your head better be on a swivel.
Totally. Or maybe I just need to get out of the game for a while because I just can't slow these guys down. They've got to figure out a way to disrupt these offenses. And typically,
Baylor has the mullet guy.
Play, and that can help change things.
West Virginia has Sean McNeil.
Right now. They run again on first down. Cook. And he's dropped.
Who the fuck
right
else
at the 40.
Who?
Gain of three. He's
tackled. I like the call there because
he doesn't even play it.
Time off the clock and get them closer to getting out of here with a W. In the mind of the play caller, all you want to hear is tick, tick.
He was so good his freshman year too, and then he fell apart last year, and then he doesn't play this year. Like he was so good his freshman year, bro.
Sometimes it's hard to figure, but you can
like he looked like Carson Edwards his freshman year and then just died. But dude, I love that Miles McBride is so good but not quite good enough to go to the NBA. That's like the greatest thing ever. Well, right, I mean that's what like he's just too small to go to the NBA and he's a sophomore and we're gonna have him for we could have him for three more years because this year doesn't count. So, if he wants. So he just tossed it away, but that brings up fourth. Smart play to get rid of it there, but now it's fourth down. Your margin for error pretty much out the window. That means you have to come up with a big time throw here and a completion in order to keep this 2 minute drive going. Yeah. Gonna be a rally, a lot of good teams in like 3 or 4 years when all the there's a million 5th-year seniors. Do you imagine if Perry Ellis fucking played this year too? Oh my god. Oh, 29-30. Indy. 29-30. Are you in? Did you get it? Let's go. All right, I'm a P. Well, let's go. Puts him in front here late, Bennett. You gotta rally your kick team, don't you? And say the last thing we need is a big return. And what happens is guys get overeager, get out of their lane because they're so excited they want to make the last tackle. You mess up, could come back at you a long way. Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Lions take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They're only in need of a field goal, a decent amount of time on the clock. So tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be too panicked here.
No, not at all. I agree with you. And this is where your preparation and your confidence comes into play. They've worked on these situations.
Yeah, they practice this all the time.
They practice it all the time. They know what they want to get done. And in a lot of cases, the great competitors, they love this situation. They think they can go ahead and get it done.
Dude, I swear to God, I know Aaron Kraft played a long time. He played for like 6 years. And Javon Carter feels like he played forever, but he only did play for 4 years. But Perry Ellis is the fucking king of playing goddamn forever. I swear to you, he played 9 years. I swear it was so fucking long that dude played. He, bro, like, honestly, he played so fucking long. I was so tired of hearing his fucking name. It was ridiculous. Ah, shit, I hit the wall. Sorry, guys. Sorry. So much for the best laid plans. All right, and best design plays. Are you in here? Good coverage along the sidelines. No place for that one to get in there. It sails in fast pasta. Golf. All right, this soccer fan guy's cold. Huh? Out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete. What is it? A little late getting there, and it's third down. The way he's throwing the football today, almost a surprise when he doesn't. Oh, is he racing this weekend? Like there, but he needs a few more to get his guys downfield. Well, the way he's throwing it, it's like the rest of the Penske cars, but what's his sponsor? Verizon. The guys going out for passes, they'll run even harder because they expect it as well. Is it red and black? Is running back. It's complete. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. A short gain that doesn't get him the first down brings up a fourth down situation.
Really nice job defensively. They knew where the sticks were. They got this.
It was him, bro. A 53-yard attempt.
Badgley able to knock this one through. And that will tie this game here in the final minute of play.
Larson or Bush?
The life of a kicker. He has not been called on the entire game. He's over there by
Bush.
The net, but they send him out here in the fourth quarter and say, hey, go tie the
game. What's his?
And guess what? He comes through.
I just don't know how they do it. I really don't. These cats
what's the color?
Are a different breed from you and me.
Oh, that's a pressure kick,
but that one was never in doubt.
I'll look at it after this race. Oh, that's right, LaGioia. Forgot about that.
Their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. They'd like to avoid overtime here, so maybe they can work the sidelines. But then defensively, how do they adjust to that if they do work the sideline?
It's the old leverage game.
Ryan Newman.
At the line of scrimmage, right? Who's going to win with the low block?
And I believe Chris Buescher.
But in this case, you're trying as a defender to leverage them ooh towards the middle of the field, not let them get to the sidelines and try and tackle them in bounds in order to run the clock.
LeBron?
Chess match here late.
What? LeBron owns a NASCAR team? Fuck. Why? From the 25. How? Wait, what? How? How does he own a NASCAR team?
This is Chenault on the receiver. Fuck, I went into the pits. And he'll be out of bounds. That was nice. Right at the 40. 15 yards on the play.
First down. First and 10 at the 40-yard line.
I don't think he's going to be rich enough, bro. It takes a lot of money to own a NASCAR team. As a running back, he's got to like make a lot of money. Now Murray. Yeah, but I mean, you got to have, to operate a successful NASCAR team, you got to have hundreds of millions of dollars every year. And you're probably losing money the first 3 or 4 years to do it. So it all rests now on the right foot of and we will get a timeout. Well, think about it. He was the, not Bill Belichick, but he was like, he was the best coach in the NFL for 15 years. And he, I think he did a lot of, like, he invested a lot as well. I don't know about big point. I mean, why do you think he has all these great relationships with DeWalt, fucking FedEx, Home Depot, like, M&M's? Like, those are sponsors that the drivers didn't get. That's sponsors that Joe gets. If they kick a field goal, though, or don't score, the other team gets a possession. And after both teams get a possession, then we're into sudden death. First team to score wins the game. He is old, but who doesn't love Joe Gibbs? Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. He does. He does. Bro, Joe Gibbs, he said that whenever he's asked of Kyle Busch, he just fucking starts laughing every time and tells some random different Kyle Busch story about how he throws a temperature in the driver's seat. It's so funny. He's like an old grandpa and he's like, oh, Kyle, one time he was pissed because I told, because I was on him about how Denny finished ahead of him at Pinoco, and he took, he took my wristwatch off my hand and threw it against the wall. The ones who are doing it best know they need to go down, attack, put the ball in the end zone, and not leave it up to a field goal to give the other team a chance. What is it? Pinoco. Wait, what is it? Pocono. That's right. I can't. I refuse to acknowledge its existence because it's such a terrible drive. He's gonna go out of bounds, but he takes Pinoco? No, wait, Pocono. Pocono. I can't say Pocono. I'm just a stew. I didn't know what Connor was living in.
Yeah, have you never heard of the Pocono?
Until I stewed about Pocono, and then he goes, it's Pocono. I was like, oh, okay.
So three plays already, first and goal, and they are wasting little time. And now the Cardinals going to use another timeout. They'll be left with just one remaining here at OT. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what
to do. I probably won't carry it first and goal. Nope. Pocono. Is that right?
Again, Goff.
Oh, what? It kicked me. There we go. I'm back in. Right now, it's still the Rover. But it's complete right around the 8. And he's going to be taken down right at the line. No gain that time on the completion, and it'll be. I'm going
to
start 30. That was impressive to me because while it was a pass play, they still. Looks like it will be the Rover. Let's go. Put the receiver on the ground. Roval. No, he switched it to Bristol at 1 second. I'm not joking. Oh my god.
You are so gay. I gotta. Hold on, guys. I gotta fix my chair.
Max be looking like a Wii character.
Oh, and it's intercepted.
able to get there and pick it. And a short return will be stopped inside the 10 at the 8-yard line.
I don't know.
A costly mistake here at OT.
And you know what they say when you throw an interception like that in overtime?
Bro, this bitch texts me. She goes, TBT to when we fucked. And I was like, what are you talking about? She goes, we fucked last weekend. And I was like, it's Wednesday, bro.
Two minutes left in this overtime session and still all tied.
Yo, fuck off, dude. I see you in that fast pasta car.
Murray do now with his drive?
Getting wrecked.
That'll be complete to Cook. And he's taken down, but able to get this up to the 20-yard line. It's a first down on a gain of 10. This being their second opportunity in overtime, third overall drive. See if they can settle into a rhythm.
And that's what you're looking for. Get a few first downs, move the ball downfield, have some confidence, get yourself in a spot where you can at least kick a field goal to win it. But I tell you this,
fuck off.
If I'm a play caller, I'm looking at that part of my sheet that says playmakers. Get the ball in their hands, critical situation, now's their time.
At the 45-yard line.
This is so much easier to control it, bro.
He's going to get it across the midfield stripe into Lion territory. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and two.
He's on the pickup, brings up second and two.
Uh-oh.
They run it again with Cook. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone. 27 yards there, a first down.
Outside handoff to the right side. If you're a running back, you love getting the ball early so you have vision to see what's happening in front of you.
Right tackle likes that call. Big play for him. But don't forget about the guys you always tell me on the backside sealing off.
When they talk about cutoff blocks, making sure no one can leak from the backside that can run a play down.
And nobody leaked. Big play. Now a second timeout called for by the defense. They'll be down to just one remaining as we step aside here in overtime. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Another tote for the workhorse this afternoon. It's Cook, and he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. 5 yards on the carry there, and it leaves him with third and about 6 yards to go.
Third and six.
He had 42, 6, and 9, Max. Wow.
So it all rests now on the right foot of Brett Maher. Now the timeout comes here in the waning seconds of this overtime as we could be set up at long last for a potential game winner. So it all rests now on the right foot of Brett Maher. Now the timeout comes here in the waning seconds of this overtime as we could be set up at long last for a potential game winner. And he got it. The kick is good.
And
overtime, he's able to split the uprights. And the Cardinals win it. We thought this game would be a good one. It did not disappoint into overtime.
He's not fucking dropping, man. You're being duped if you think he's dropping. It's not gonna. He's baiting us again because he's an asshole and likes to do that shit.
In this case, they got the ball back on defense, gave themselves a chance, and they capitalized on it with a victory.
And I don't care.
It's probably gonna be an announcement that he's gonna be a feature on someone's album coming out in 3 months.
Your snapper, your holder.
Oh, that's what it is. Fuck. Of course he's not dropping. We figured it out. God damn it. Uh-oh, my wheel fell off.
Oh my god, Max, I won that game. I know, you know, I was sweating that in my entire... I literally was not speaking for like two... I sweated my ass off.
Bro, I literally cannot tighten it anymore. I think it's my desk. No, it's not my dinner tray. It's my desk. Yeah.
It's
It might be that. I might be jerking it too hard. I'm trying to be too good. Like, I'm trying to be like Kyle Busch. Or, I mean, Kyle Larson, sorry. She just said, fuck you.
What, bruh?
Ah, my boy.
Dude, I can't believe I won that game. Holy shit.
My wheel falls off a lot at Bristol. It's just like drinking is so hard. At Bristol, that's what it requires. That's why yours doesn't fall off, because you race Bristol. Don't worry, 21's coming out soon, bud. It'll come out when Leroy's album comes out. Let's see. You know, I'm going to look at Justin Bieber's Twitter, see if he released the track list. Well, yeah, but like what song he's on. I'm like a finger 11. Take what? A second. I'm finna send it like a parent. A message to the best. If it ain't me, then you need you a confession. You a mess. Interview. MLK is dead, bruh.
Interlude.
I thought you said interview. I was like, bro, you've been dead for a long time, little bruh. Plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And now he spin the block around just like the hell in the clock. No. He wouldn't drop on some of the features on Bieber. Yeah, he's not gonna drop on the same day. And now he spin the block around just like the hell in the clock. She like the hands of the clock. I go back to bat when I'm doing numbers. All the mad that I'm dropping the bus, so they threw me under. Heard they mad, they don't wanna bust, so they boo each other. Think that they're the winning team, go losing, then they choose another. And that's okay, cause that's I'm weird. For me, not you. I live with blessings like I can't stop sneezing, not you. I hate to break a boy, me and myself talk too. I blow away the competition like a ball of hot soup. There's no catch. I go and get the bag and I'm not bringing it back. I'm like a down QB. I put the pain in the past. And if you ever had a problem, promise I didn't ask. So it's 444 in the karma dash. I shake a pic, told them all you went first, you last. Little boy, that's facts. I'm a
oh,
cash
shit.
To my money. Yo, fuck off. And yeah, we did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top once again. Yeah, I had to tighten the plan. Yeah. I
got it right in the end. Now we on top, top once again. I don't want it if it ain't love. If it ain't, get it away from me. Who you gon' jack if it ain't us? LABB to the bakery. Some mad that I came up. I know my granny gon' pray for me. It was just us in the vacancy. We had to get it from A to B. Wheels never felt like this. Two seats in the hills, how I feel righteous. Blue sheets for the mills, but the deal priceless. New keys can't care what's still private. I might just double it up, did it. Never enough, I'm with it. 5-2-3 on the business, whole team got wins. And the wheels are spinning, I told them. What I told them. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah, hey. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top. Got a spot and it's locked to the click all in. I got ops, if he drop, I just hit my dance. I was pop, they just watched, had to take my wins. They wouldn't let me in. I've been on 10-10 cents. Who really holding it down? I've been holding it down and I go it again and again. Who was the dummy that died? I'm the coldest around, but he falling again and again. I'm in the what? I'm in the day. I'm doing 30 on 30 and up. You in the what? You in the way. Either you rolling or rolling the dust. You with us or what? Keep it running. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again.
Yeah.
I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the air. Now we on top, top once again. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah.
Oh my god.
It's my birthday.
I'm in.
So
I'm in. I think I have. I'm pretty sure. I can check. I'll check. I'm pretty sure I have. Wait, is it Gloria? Oh, happy birthday! Listen,
the minute of
hey,
night.
You know who wished you a happy birthday first last year? Me. Yeah, I remember. It was like 12:01, and I came in. No, you were here. Maybe I called you. I remember something. I was the first one to wish you a happy birthday.
You'll have absolutely no idea what the hell. But I mean, it's fine. Like me and Easton,
okay. You should listen to this Young Nugget song. It's actually kind of fire. I ain't going out sad just to look at some boobs. Yo. Oh my god, thank you, Bessie. I'm stupid. I don't even die like a stupid mission going bad. Oh boy, already a wreck. Perfect young man, I got swag for days. A dump truck gas, but we need to for a minute if he plays this match. Won't be a slave because you give me a boner. Wait, what happened to my rearview mirror? How do I turn that shit back on? How do I get turned? I'm in the apron. How is that possible? Now I am in 19th. Fuck you. I will try. Bro, that was so funny when Fast Pasta almost just killed Alex Bowman a couple weeks ago. You remember that? Like, he was trying to pit, and Fast Pasta just absolutely flew by on the inside. I was like, what the fuck? No. Greatest slaves. Miley Cyrus, private jet, private pilot. Look at me, stylish. Masterpiece, body. Dumb. Hey, I don't know no, but I'm on this every day. You cannot run with me, but I'm everywhere. Baby, I know what's coming, I could barely wait. And when it was on, they wanted me gone, but I'm here to stay. I can see you. Are you like in a group of three? Nathan's is way better. Nathan's is king. Yeah, Nathan's and Ballpark are the ways to go. Nathan's Frank. Not in this guy's draft, bro.